European champion gold medalists back in 2016 and 2020. These two athletes, so much respect for one another. They know each other so well. The handshake, the greeting.
Mutual respect between these two.
And now 6 minutes of war between these two legends of the sport. Taha Gul looking for his 10th European championship. Geno Petriasvili looking for number three.
Geno just taking the fingers from Akgol there, just reminding him it's not going to be an easy one for you tonight, my friend.
What has allowed Akgul to have the upper hand in the head-to-heads?
Akgul, his conditioning for somebody at 125 kilo is so unknown, and he's got a beautiful front ankle shot. The way he drops down to that foot that's leading of his opponent. Doesn't matter if it's left or right, he's got that so good in his arsenal, and a heavyweight, that's such a good weapon to have. Let's not forget, both these men are 125 kilos, but you watch him move, you watch him shift, he can move for somebody in like 74 kilos.
You would ask anybody, not just in Europe, but across the world, heavyweight, give me three names, freestyle, 125. These two are going to be up in
these,
that conversation.
These two are stood on the mat right now, yeah.
Anywhere you go on the globe, Petriasvili and Akgul scoreless as we hit the halfway point in period one.
Well, you just see these two men in the home nations, how respected, how loved they are, just from public, not even wrestling fans, but Akgul walks through his hometown and he's treated like a king there. The same goes for Petriasvili, the exact same.
It's entertaining to watch these two go at it. They know each other so well, and you know they're very methodical, very casual with their deliberations until when they make up the mind to shoot. Petriasvili with the first shot, but Akgul is able to get to the corner.
And that's exactly what I was talking about. Akgul, he's got such light feet for somebody at that weight. He can cut the corner so easy. And he's going to roll in for 2 points there also. Beautiful. You see, this was a little bit different than the normal gut wrench he goes for. He's going high on the chest.
Usually settles in along the belly button, but he went up around the pecs, gets the two on the turn, plus the activity point as well.
Activity time, yeah, exactly. I think this was a little bit of tactics from Akgul here. When, as you can see on Petriasvili, he's got his shoulder taped up. It looks like he's got a little bit of a problem there. And if you go high on the chest and you start to turn in this situation, all that pressure comes on that shoulder on the side that you're turning, especially if you have your hand out.
Coach, please sit up, please.
They will bring out the medical team to work with Petriasvili. Right shoulder right now is the attention that he's getting.
And if you saw Akgul, he rolled him exactly the way where his right shoulder was, where it was taped up. See, over that right shoulder. Up. If that's the case, it's very tactically done by Taha Akgul in that situation.
You sense a weakness, where do you go?
Yeah, you go for that point, exactly.
Back to the feet. Akgul, though, with a 5-point exchange. And with his defense, Petriasvili now looking at a real, real stiff uphill climb.
You know, you're wrestling against someone against, so like the likes of Taha Akgul in this situation, you're 5 points down. It's very difficult to try and claw yourself back into this without tiring yourself out too much. Akgul just dominating the middle of the mat here, just keeping there nice in the middle. Both being cautioned for finger grabbing in this situation. These old boys with those old tricks.
Petriasvili grew up around Gori, which is a wrestling hotbed in the country of Georgia. And the period goes to Agul, a 5-0 lead for Turkey.
Yeah, better start as Taha Agul, you couldn't be having right now.
Agul, the Rio Olympic champion in 2016. It was a Tokyo bronze medalist, but when it comes to the Continentals, this has been his stage.
Yeah, this man is on fire in this Continental Championships. You need to think, Sean, he's going for his 11th European title. So there's 11 years where he's been the top dog in this Continental Championships. That's one big ask. And to be doing it for so long as well and so consistent.
He's won a couple in Serbia, won one in Georgia, ironically, Finland, Dagestan, Budapest, Bucharest. He's been all over. Yeah. He takes the talent on
That's
the road.
A nice shot from Gino there, but beautiful sprawl from Agul there. He's going to cut the corner again. This is exactly what I mean from Taha Agul. He's beautiful in the way he moves his feet as a. And he's going again for that right shoulder. Now he's switching to the left side. He's got the 2 points again.
Agul, one turn away from ending it early against Petrius Bili, but they go out of bounds. Saw Geno pound the mat with his right fist in frustration.
In frustration there, yeah. I mean, you go in your best shot that you've got, and Agul just sprawls out of it as if it's nothing and takes the two, and then gut wrenches you again for the 2 points. It's a good shot by Pichikashvili here, but Agul again cutting that corner very fast. Let's see if he can do it now.
If he can free up his left leg, he's going to win another title.
Gino holding on for dear life in this situation. Refusing to let go of that leg.
Triashvili with the last couple of shots. Still nothing to show for it. Inside 2 minutes to go. Huge lead for Agul.
Petriashvili really needs to try something now. There's 1.5 minutes left. If he's going to put some points on the board, he needs to start using his hands a little more. He can't be backing off from Agul here. Agul just wants him there.
Agul not moving. He's staying stationary. He's going to make Petriashvili come to him. A comfortable lead late. 5 in the first period. 4 more here in the second for Taha Agul.
That's a nice shot there from Gino. He's just going to switch his way out. There you go, gets his 2 points. That was much better. Instead of going directly at Agul, he's gone round him. He's cut that corner again. He's going to shoot him for that leg lace. It's tight. Looks like he's going to get it in. If he can, he's going to roll him here, it looks like. He's almost... Oh, he just stopped just on the moment where he was going to go.
Agul wanting a whistle and a stoppage, not getting it. Petriashvili gives one more thrust. Good parterre defense underneath. It looked like for a moment that Petriashvili was on to something.
Yeah, Agul just looked like he was going to come out of position, and Petriashvili just stopped in that moment. If he just kept going for 2 more seconds, he would have taken him out there.
In the finger interlocking, and Agul grimacing in pain. Another lecture coming from the referee with 19 seconds to go. Yep. Petriashvili.
Petriashvili again. There you go. Beautiful work. You see, but he wasn't doing this earlier in the match. This.
Petriashvili with a couple of late takedowns. Yep. He wanted to go right back to work on the feet, but yep, he is not going to have enough time. Taha Agul adds another chapter, his 10th European championship. You factor in the European Games, he's up to 11.
He will climb at the top of the podium at the European Championships for the 10th time. 10th time European champion.
What a result, what an achievement from this man from Turkey. Bichugashvili just turned on the burners a little bit too late there. You could see the way he was moving in that last 45 seconds. That's the Bichugashvili that I know from past competitions where he has beaten Taha.